Selecting the wrong probe tip or ground leads will reduce your probe's bandwidth and create signal distortion due to loading. To maximize the bandwidth and minimize the loading effects, learn about these steps that will guide you away from the pitfall of using the wrong probe accessories. Hi, I'm Erin. In this episode of Probing Pitfalls, you'll learn about some of the common accessories for single-ended active probes and what effects they have on your signal. Engineers often think accessories are perfect because they make the probe-to-duct connection easier, but they don't realize how much these accessories may be limiting their measurements. When looking at accessories, it's important to think about the impacts of bandwidth, signal fidelity, and loading. We learned about the pitfalls of not having enough bandwidth and how to go about finding the correct amount in the first episode. Well, all of that hard work finding the perfect probe bandwidth could quickly go to waste if you don't consider the impact from your accessories. Connection bandwidth is really important to think about. The shorter the connection is between the probe tip and your device under test, the higher the bandwidth of the system will be. The longer the leads, the higher the inductance is that's felt on your circuit. This inductance forms an LC circuit with the probe tip capacitance and any other parasitic capacitances. The result of this will be a lower amplitude, slower rise time, and rounder edges, which will make all of your measurements inaccurate. To take a closer look at the bandwidth impact and signal fidelity using accessories, let's analyze this 125 megahertz square wave. The yellow trace shows the true signal that's being fed right into the oscilloscope from the generator. Note that the true rise time of the signal is 104 picoseconds. We can see what the signal looks like in green using an active probe with no accessories attached. This signal has the same rise time as channel 1, and we can see a lot of signal detail since we have the shortest connection possible and enough bandwidth. Now, if I attach the probe using the Y lead adapter, we can see that there's already quite a bit of loading on the true signal on channel 1 just from connecting the Y lead adapter to the DUT. This loading is going to greatly affect the rise time. Looking at the result of the probe with the Y lead on channel 3, we can see that the edges are a bit more rounded because there isn't enough bandwidth to capture the critical harmonics. And we can also see that the rise time of the measurement is only around 2.5 nanoseconds because of the loading caused by this accessory. Lastly, on channel 4, we have the longest connection using the Y lead adapters and the flex nose grabbers. You can see the signal is completely distorted because we don't have enough bandwidth at all with this connection. And the loading is even worse. This visualization of the response using different accessories helps to understand how this component can change the rise time of your response you're seeing on screen along with the bandwidth of your system. Looking back at channel 2, the probe using the shortest connection, one other observation you may be questioning is why the signal using the ground blade has more ringing than what we saw with the Y lead adapter. For our example here, I purposely selected a signal with a really fast rise time simply to demonstrate and explain this ringing. Ringing will occur when either the capacitance or the inductance at the probe tip are too high. This formula helps to understand that a little bit better. You can use this to see what the resonant frequency is as the capacitance and the inductance vary. The lower the capacitance and inductance are, the higher the resonant frequency will be. Typically, we want the resonant frequency to be higher than the frequency of the probe in the circuit that you're working with. In this case, the capacitance and the inductance at the probe tip are too high, which means the resonant frequency is lower than our bandwidth and therefore causing ringing on our signal. So you can see it's really important to ensure you're using the right probe tips and accessories for your measurement. Each accessory option has its own trade-offs on bandwidth impact, signal fidelity, and loading. But understanding some common mistakes and best practices helps you select the accessories you need. To avoid the pitfalls of added inductance by longer lead accessories, remember these two tips. Use the shortest possible accessory leads to see the best representation of your circuit's performance and signal fidelity. Use longer lead accessories to get quick general measurements such as troubleshooting when you don't care about sacrificing the bandwidth. To learn how to avoid other probing pitfalls, check out this link and subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.